Local Lifestyles continues.
Welcome back this morning. We are really excited right now to have photographer Mark A. Lee with us, and he's going to tell us about an exhibit that he's curating called A Visual Journey from AIDS to Marriage Equality, and it is now at the Evansville Museum. So, Mark, this has been your idea, and it's been something that's been going for you for 30 years, you just told me. Mm-hmm. So, a lifetime to put this all together. So, tell us a little bit about it.
I'm a photographer from the Indianapolis area, so I've been taking pictures over about 35 years now. It wasn't until the early 80s when a lot of my friends started dying from AIDS, and I was documenting part of their life.
Right, so that's how it all kind of began.
That really began forming and becoming more important for me to document our history. And so about 5 years ago, I approached the head of the Indiana Historical Society and about having exhibit there, and so he loved the idea, and so we ended up having the exhibit there in 2014.
I think we have a picture of that we might show here in just a few minutes of you standing with the exhibit all around you. How did it go over there at the Historical Society?
Oh, it was great. We had 600 people opening night, and so it was one of the best attended exhibits.
So now you brought it to us here in Evansville at the Evansville Museum, and tonight you're doing a talk about it.
Yes.
Okay. Tell us what time that is.
It's at 6:30 this evening at the museum. And I'll just be talking briefly about it and then answering any questions that people have.
And then they can view the exhibit, right? Okay, so this does have a little bit of a cost. It's $12 for adults. This is for tonight. Youth is $8, but members to the Evansville Museum are free. So I think we can kind of take a look at some of the pictures that are there. Tell us a little bit about this one. This is one of them that's in the exhibit.
This is actually the very first picture I ever took for the exhibit itself.
Okay.
This is, at the time, she was a female impersonator by the name of Vicki Lane, who's since transitioned to become female. And so I was doing a calendar in Bloomington, Indiana, about kings and queens, and she was the first person to volunteer to pose for the calendar. So, but that laugh of hers really
smile.
Captures her entire essence. And yeah, I just loved it. And actually, the very first, so unfortunately, she passed away from cancer about a year ago, she wasn't able to make it to the opening of the exhibit, but when
in Indianapolis,
but when she actually did go to the exhibit, she wrote to me and let me know that, you know, she'd been going through cancer treatments the last 2 years, and she was really going through a lot, dealing with, you know, trying to figure out if her life meant anything. And when she took one look at that picture and she saw it on the wall, she knew that.
That's a powerful thing. Let's take a look at another one here that you sent to us. Tell us about this one.
This was actually right after DOMA was struck down in 2013, somewhere around there.
Yes, that's what you said.
So that's the State House, and those are the kids from IYG that are standing around the rainbow flag.
That's pretty. Let's take a look now at the last picture that we have real quick here, and that's you, I believe, in the exhibit that you did at the Indiana Historical Society. There you are.
Yes.
So how many pictures do you have? Do you know?
I've actually donated over 18,000 photographs to the Historical Society and narrowed it down to 60 photographs for this exhibit.
Narrowed it down to 60. Okay, so the talk that you're doing is tonight. The exhibit, though, is going all the way until June 27th at the Evansville Museum.
Correct.
So
thank
you so much for bringing this to us out here in Evansville, and thanks for coming in today.
Thank you very much for having me.
And we will be right back after this. So actually, first we need to check in with Ron, and then...